Bhagavad Gita, as it is, we are at the introduction. Arjuna vacha, yoyam yogastvaya proktaha samyena madhusudana etasyaham na pashyami chanchalatvat sthitim sthiram. Arjuna said, O Madhusudan, the system of yoga which you have summarized appears impractical and endurable to me, for the mind is restless and unsteady. In the sixth chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna told Arjuna, okay, you engage in meditation. And then meditation, but Arjuna, 5,000 years ago, now we are in Kali Yuga, 5,000 years ago, people had longer lives. That was Dwapar Yuga. They were more self-controlled. Their minds was not so agitated. He told him that this yoga system, this meditation is impractical. Why? Because the mind is restless and unsteady. So how much more relevant it is to us today? So what is the correct way of doing yoga? What is the correct meditation? But the Lord says, yoginam api sarvesham mat gate nantar atmana shraddhavan bhajate yomam same yukta tamo mataha. Of all yogis, the one with great faith who always abides in me, thinks of me within himself and renders transcendental loving service to me, is the most intimately united with me in yoga and is the highest of all. That is my opinion. 6.47. So Krishna is saying, one who with great faith, have faith in Krishna. He's saying that, have faith in me, abides in me, think of me, and render transcendental loving service to me. Render service to Krishna. That is devotional service. Devotional service begins by hearing and chanting. So one who thinks of the Supreme Lord always is the greatest yogi, the supermost jnani, and the greatest devotee at the same time. So some people just wants to be a yogi. Then they are just yogi, they are not jnani or bhakta. There is some person who want to be only a jnani, but they are no yogis, they are not yogis or they are not bhaktas. But one who is a devotee of the Lord is also a yogi, a jnani, and a devotee. The Lord further tells Arjuna that as a kshatriya, why is that? Why is a devotee having also a jnani and a yogi? Why? Because he has the jnana. I'm not this body. I'm the super soul. I'm not the super soul, but the soul. That I'm the soul. And I have, as a soul, I have certain activities to do. You know, what are my duties as a soul? So he has the jnana. And the devotee, why is he the greatest yogi? Because he's always meditating on Krishna, on Krishna's instructions, on chanting the holy name, on his pastimes. You know? So the Lord further tells Arjuna that as a kshatriya, he cannot give up his fighting. But if Arjuna fights remembering Krishna, then he will be able to remember Krishna at the time of death. But one must be completely surrendered in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. So, Krishna, because Arjuna was saying, I will give up my occupation. I don't want to fight. Krishna is saying, you fight. Don't give up your duties, because that's artificial renunciation. You sit, you do your duty and just engage in devotional service. Follow the instructions of Krishna as given in Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita. We work not with our body actually, but with our mind and intelligence. So if the intelligence and the mind are always engaged in the thought of the Supreme Lord, then naturally the senses are also engaged in his service. Superficially, at least, the activities of the senses remain the same, but the consciousness is changed. The Bhagavad Gita teaches one how to absorb the mind and intelligence in the thought of the Lord. So this is what we are going to learn in Bhagavad Gita, how we change our consciousness. How can we change our thoughts? How can we change our intelligence? Such absorption will enable one to transfer himself to the kingdom of the Lord. And by just doing that, what will happen? We can go back home, back to Godhead, the kingdom of the Lord, Golok Vrindavan. The mind is engaged in Krishna's service. Then the senses are automatically engaged in his service. This is the art, and this is also the secret of Bhagavad Gita. Total absorption in the thought of Sri Krishna. So, and how we can absorb our mind and senses? Then we try to, what we are seeing, try to see the deity pictures, see the devotees, and then hearing about Krishna, hearing about his devotees, eat Krishna prasad, like that. And so then our mind and senses are both absorbed in Krishna. That's what he says. Man mana bhava mad bhakta. Yeah. Let's just say this. Modern man has struggled very hard to reach the moon, but he has not tried very hard to elevate himself spiritually. If one has 50 years of life ahead of him, he should engage that brief time in cultivating this practice of remembering the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So if we think we are going to live for 50 years more, then we should. That is called as a brief time. We might say, oh, 50 years, such a long time. But if we see how much of our time is going to be utilized in sleeping, in eating, in defending, you know, actually how much time do we have? Not very long. And in that time, we should try very hard to follow the process, elevate ourselves spiritually, get self-realized, you know. What is that true self-realization? That I am a spirit soul, I am a part and parcel of Krishna, I am a servant of Krishna, and I have an eternal loving relationship with Krishna. So, we can stop here for today. Any thoughts, comments, questions? No, then we can stop here. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Shrila Prabhupada ki jai, Gaura Premanand, Hari Hari Bol, Hare Krishna.